And welcome everybody to Simon Fraser University atop the beautiful Burnaby Mountain campus here at Simon Fraser University. The Thursday GNAC men's basketball night has arrived here in Simon Fraser, coming off an especially tough northern swing through the great state of Alaska, where they lost two of the biggest heartbreakers you can suffer back to back on the road in this conference. Coming back here with the playoffs, not mathematically out of the picture, but about as tough as you could possibly imagine, with three more games remaining. The Simon Fraser team set to take on Central Washington here today. A Wildcats team in the thick of the hunt, one of the top teams in the conference this year. So it's going to be a tremendous test for Simon Fraser to bounce back from the disappointment of those losses in Alaska and come back here and try and get a win. Who are some of the main people going to be that the Red Leafs will lean on? Well, let's talk about Zach Stone. He just came by our broadcast location here before the start of this contest to say hello, and he has been producing at a great pace here. Number 21, the 7-footer out of Louis Riel High, doing a great job here for the Red Leafs this season. 14 points in the loss to Alaska Fairbanks on Saturday, that 74-71 loss. Of course, there was that triple overtime loss the night before, so a heartbreaking swing, as we said, through Alaska. The last time these two teams played, back in late January, Simon Fraser really not in the contest, losing 92-68. To the Wildcats in Ellensburg. But Stone was a double-figure scorer on a night when Simon Fraser only scored 68 points. He had 12 points there. So the big man getting it done in the score column, and should be a very interesting guy to watch today. Of course, we have to mention number 11. That's Emmanuel Oladele. He has been tremendous for Simon Fraser in so many areas, especially helping this team get into a flow with some tempo in the offense. Oladele, 10 points and 8 rebounds in that 71-74 loss Saturday to the Nanooks in Fairbanks, Alaska, averaging 8.1 points, 4.4 rebounds per game in conference play. Emmanuel Oladele set to be an important part of what happens here today. And of course, as we count down to his final three games as a Simon Fraser Red Leaf, it's the senior point guard David Penny in the top 20 in GNAC scoring in conference play this season. Number 3, Penny, 14.8 points per game. He has assumed the team lead in points once more. David Penny, productive at every turn here for Simon Fraser this year, their leader, and coming off of an 8-for-16 performance from the field, a game high, or a team high rather, 18 points in that loss to Fairbanks on the weekend. He went to 8-of-16, 2-of-4 from beyond the arc. Simon Fraser, though, in a game they lost by only 3 points, only managed 2 free throw attempts in the entire game. I don't know how that's even possible, but Simon Fraser on the weekend, 1-of-2 from the free throw line. Who else can we talk about? What about the man in charge of this program? Steve Hansen really got a great resurgence in the program for a huge stretch of this season, putting his team on the brink of a playoff contention. And as we mentioned off the top, the playoffs are going to be tough here now for Simon Fraser. They have 3 games left. Steve Hansen, the veteran coach, really got his team playing on a great swing, and as we said, trying to bounce back from those 2 losses in Alaska. That is going to be a tough task here. At double overtime, not triple, 83-81, the loss at Anchorage a week ago today, 74-71, as we said, at Fairbanks. So 2 losses on the road by a grand total of 5 points. And that's a tough pill to swallow for Simon Fraser, who come in with a 4-11 record. If they had won them both, they'd be 6-9, right at the edge of contention with Western Washington, whom they will play in the final game of this season in early March. So things didn't roll Simon Fraser's way on that road trip. Steve Hansen, the man who wants to see the changes come back, get his team in a groove for these final 3 games, and don't worry about anything else but just trying to get a W each night. It's going to be a big challenge here tonight as the Central Washington Wildcats are in town today. Central Washington, number 3 in scoring in the conference, are averaging 7.7 points per game. The record of this team heading in the conference is 8-6, so they're 2 games above 500, but they've got a scoring margin, I believe that's 3rd in the conference, plus 9.1 points. So when they've won big. We will look to see what they are all about today. The guy to mention here, Samad Hector, at 6'6". He's a senior out of Brooklyn, New York, and a transfer, a D1 drop-down from Sacramento State where he played for the Hornets. He is here for his senior season, averaging a team-leading 13.2 points per game and 9.3 rebounds per game. Samad Hector wearing number 24 for the Central Washington Wildcats. Another score to look at is Bennett O'Connor, a redshirt freshman out of Mount Si High School in Seattle, Washington, averaging 12.2 points per game. He's the second leading scorer on this team. You look at this rotation there, it is filled with seniors and first-year players. A real contrast there, the experience and the talented youth movement for head coach Brandon Rinta, who was just here chatting with head coach Steve Hansen a moment ago. So it's going to be an exciting one here as we get down to about a minute to go. Our officials for tonight's game will be Rob Smith Jr., Derek Davis, and Anthony Gregory. Simon Fraser will continue play right here on Saturday against the Northwest Nazarene squad, the Nighthawks in town. And they will wrap up the season, as we said, March the 2nd against Western Washington. That's a 7 p.m. game, I believe, or 7:30. You'll check your schedules. But it'll be a doubleheader with the women's game. And the officials coming by to greet us here at the minor officials table as we get set to go with this contest here on the penultimate weekend of play in the GNAC regular season. We'll hear a buzzer in about 15 seconds. We will take a break for the national anthems and the starting lineups and be back with the opening tip right here from the West Gym. Howard Samura here, Red Leafs TV, back with more in moments.
Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to the West Gym for tonight's game between the visiting Central Washington University Wildcats and your Simon Fraser University SFU men's basketball team to the court to present the Student-Athlete Unity Pledge.
I am an NCAA student-athlete, and I pledge to be a champion of unity on my team, on my campus, and in my community. I pledge to stand against all forces of division and separation. I pledge to embrace differences and strive for inclusion and collaboration. I pledge to stand against racism, hate, and discrimination. I pledge to strive for love, care, and forgiveness. I pledge to stand against silence, deceit, and obscurity. I pledge to strive for dialogue, truth, and understanding.
I pledge to stand against fear and doubt. I pledge to strive for trust and belief in one another. I pledge to stand against complacency and stagnancy. I pledge to strive for change and growth. I commit to supporting my fellow student athletes in all circumstances that impact them. I commit to both choosing unity personally and encouraging it for all. I pledge these things because we are stronger together, united as one.
And now, basketball fans, at this time, we ask that you welcome to the floor, from Coquitlam, British Columbia, the Roy Stibbs Elementary School Choir, led by Angie Lundy. And now, fans, at this time, we do ask that you please rise, if you are able, and please remove all caps for the singing of the American and Canadian national anthems.
Thank you so much. As we get set, the referees dropping their warm-up jackets, conveniently right in front of my broadcast location. Larissa Dillon here, keeping everything neat and tidy for us here. The minor officials table, Steve Hansen and the SFU starters. They will be David Penny, number 3, Eric Beckett, number 10, Emmanuel Oladele, number 11, Elliot DeMackey Langan, number 20, Zach Stone, 21. For the Central Washington Wildcats, 0, Jordan Clark, number 3, is Bradley Swilly, Cameron McNeil, number 11, 24, Samad Hector, the leading scorer, and Maverick Sanders, the 6'6 freshman out of Mount Spokane. The Wildcats in their road blacks with wine trim, the Simon Fraser Red Leafs and their home whites, resplendent red and piping as well, as the opening tip gets us underway right to the senior, David Penny. Simon Fraser just living for the moment tonight, doing what they can here and trying to get back on a bit of a roll with three more games remaining in this regular season. Let everything fall as it may. DeMackey Lang in the handoff. Right to the window goes Elliott. Had a great look at it. Couldn't kiss it off the glass. The rebound there by Hector. He comes in averaging 9.3 caroms per game. Sanders, number 33. We talked about him right off the top. Swilly. Pulling up from the elbow. That shot a bit strong there from McNeil. Cameron McNeil with a nice attempt at the basket out of Raleigh, North Carolina. Here's Eric Beckett, the University of Vermont transfer. What a story he's been coming down the stretch drive of this season. Getting healthy again and really helping his Red Leafs team. Stone for 3, right in rhythm. The big man making no mistake. Double-figure scorer for this team, Zach Stone. Showing his offensive identity this season. When you get fed so nicely in the half-court set and rhythm, Stone, a guy that can knock that down all day. Here's Sanders, tough shot right into Oladele. And I think a tough break here for Emmanuel. He was coming up in terms of gaining position, and they will get Oladele with the foul. Sanders, key little turnaround move there to draw the defender, get him in the air. And the first team foul there is our ace replay staff showing you everything that's happening in this West Gym. Our camera operators today, and our thanks to Julia Hansen and Jose Castro for their efforts in the West Gym today as the first free throw there by Maverick Sanders. All name GNAC, number 33, 6'6", 200 pounds out of Mount Spokane, as we mentioned. And he makes the second. So Simon Fraser with the basketball and a 3-1 lead early. Here's Penny. Another freshman, Jordan Clark, guarding him. Jordan out of Seattle Christian. Here's Stone, the handoff to Elliott to Maculangan. Oladele knifing through the paint, pulls it off his hip and lays it off the window. Emmanuel Oladele, 5-1 Red Leafs lead. Smooth as silk and really coming into his own. Cannot wait to see Elliott to Maculangan next season, but three more games left here for Red Leafs fans in the regular season. Swilly. A look at three there, skying rebound from Demaculangan as the miss there by Samad Hector. Stone, one-on-one in the block. Zach kicks it back out. Oladele thought about the three. Demaculangan the same thing, but he knifes and goes, looking for Beckett in the far baseline corner, intercepted there by Cameron McNeil. And that ignites the fast break. The turnover costs Simon Fraser as Bradley Swilly able to score the basketball. First field goal of the game now. For Central Washington, make it 5-3. Stone again being fed in rhythm, and he knocks it down. Zach pointing at the bench as he knocks down his second triple in under 3 minutes of play. Simon Fraser now with the 8-3 lead. Swilly trying to shake Beckett, kicks it back. From the wing, Stone imposing with that 7-foot wingspan. Able to get to Samad Hector. A lot of starting fives and combinations here for the head coach Steve Hansen this season. Moving Beckett into that group with Stone has really kind of looked solid here. Here's Oladele back up top, again feeding the big man. This time, Maverick Sanders getting in the way, gets a hand and a tiny piece of that one, I think. Here's McNeil. The post lob underneath, Oladele. You thought Emmanuel was in the air caught, but he somehow rejects it. Beckett, a great play. They get it all the way back down to the other end of the floor. Nice stop by the Red Leafs here in the first 4 minutes of play. Penny. Every trick in the book. David Penny reaching deep into the bag there. And number three shakes the defender, creates his own opportunity in the deep paint. 10-3, Simon Fraser. Rising, Stone with a hand in the face of number 11, Cameron McNeil. And Simon Fraser right now, they're bringing the one and done stuff on defense to Central Washington. Penny tries to score amidst two Wildcats, and Central Washington is going to call a timeout here. Take a look at that replay. Here is Penny, the up, the under, the scoop, and the smooch off the window for David Penny. As we mentioned, the leading scorer on this Red Leafs team. Penny coming up out into this game, averaging almost 15 a game in the conference. 3.6 rebounds, 3.8 assists per game. Three blocks for good measure in conference play as well for Mr. Penny. And what a contributor he's been over his career here with the Simon Fraser Red Leafs. Check out Emmanuel Oladele from the Sky Cam. Oladele, smooth as silk, I think the best three words you can sometimes say about him, but he does it with power and finesse. And great to see that. Simon Fraser getting off to a 4-for-7 start from the field here. 2-of-3 from beyond the arc, both of those, of course, from the big man Zach Stone. Central Washington frustrated with a 1-6 start. They're only a basket that by Bradley Swilly, who had the N1 opportunity. So Central Washington shooting 1-of-6. Simon Fraser 4-of-7 in the early going here. And a good job by the Red Leafs to have the start they want at home right here at the West Gym. Of course, we mentioned in the pregame show, and you can join us for the pregame show every day, or every game rather, men's or women's, 7 minutes before the scheduled start time. We'll break down the matchups. We'll look at four important Simon Fraser Red Leafs to watch in each game. And take you through the matchups, take you around the conference today is Simon Fraser. We mentioned that trip to Alaska was a heartbreaker. Hey, how about an 83-81 double overtime loss at Anchorage last Thursday? That is a heartbreaker. And then to go to Fairbanks and to lose 74-71 in a one possession game there. All after flying north to Alaska. Simon Fraser gets back to the top of Burgundy Mountain. They retrench and they want to have the best three games of their season over these next three contests, beginning here tonight with Central Washington. Beckett in the paint, muscling. Beckett almost got that one to fall. Central Washington making some changes as Mitch Breezy now in the game wearing number 44. He's a load, 6'9", 225. 1-1 on the post against Mr. Stone. The double's not coming. Breezy will take it. Stone does just enough. Does he do it again? He does. The key here not to foul, but to get in his face, and what a job, but another offensive rebound. After all of that, they finally cash in. Simon Fraser did everything they could, but Colby Jeanette able to score the basketball there. And these changes being made by Brandon Rinta during the timeout. More lively off the window. Demaculangan right to the rim. The great cut to the basket by Elliot Demaculangan. And he does not miss. Elliott with a great job to lay it up and in. Simon Fraser, 12-5 is the score. Once again, contesting in the paint. And Central Washington finding some things that are working for them. They are getting second and third chances underneath the basket. As Beckett takes a seat, Mattis Van Bylett, number 5, out of Hansworth Secondary, North Vancouver. Redshirt freshman now on the floor for the Red Leafs. Van Bylent, we love the versatility we've seen from number 5 throughout his redshirt freshman season. Oladele into traffic. A tip by Demaculangan, can't get it to go. And again, the subbing of the Wildcats paying dividends with Jeanette again getting a hand on a ball. Take a look underneath on the Red Leaf replay. Now, we may not go that far into the replay, but Jeanette has been impressive in those fingertip stats in terms of keeping balls alive and keeping balls out of the basket at the Wildcats defensive end of the floor. Here's Demaculangan, double team comes quickly. Out of that active zone defense, there's Penny for three from the top, had a great look at it. Ooh, Van Bylent came over the top. No foul called there as the rebound gobbled up there by Jeanette. Angelo Lloyd, they call him Jello. Down he goes to Jeanette, baseline to Breezy. Breezy finds a cutter. Oh, look at the ball movement in the half court with a left hand and the finish underneath. A great job. I believe that was Calvin Holden, number 2, also off the bench out of Apple Valley, California, R.A. Long High School. Pulling up for three, bingo. They knock down the deep three. Angelo Lloyd, that 5-point swing pulls the Wildcats to within 2 at 12-10, a one-possession game here. They took a quantum leap based on how slow and rusty their offense looked over the first stages of this game. Oh. Demaculangan getting it done on his rear end in the paint. But finally out of bounds, and the ball will now go back to the Wildcats. Oh, yeah. 12-10, we got a ball game that we knew we'd have here. Simon Fraser needs to show they can weather the storm here, as new activity and a new group on the floor has made a big difference here for this Wildcats team. And as their starting group simmers, Breezy is going to go to the window. So rim protection right now is needed for Simon Fraser. Think of all the second chance opportunities and the ease with which Breeze breezed to the basket, pardon the pun, to lay that one up and in for a 12-12 tie. Here's Stone. Double team comes underneath the basket. Stone, oh, they're going to say he stepped on the end line, and a tough break there for Zach Stone, who played it physical. Take a look. As our clan replay shows, a nice job there defensively, and that is Jeanette. This kid, this junior out of Post Falls, Idaho, has done a terrific job at 6'4", 195. He comes in, and if he's not scoring, he's still affecting the play in a huge way. Colby Jeanette averaging 15.2 points per game. Does not start. Breezy loves to cut to the basket. He does it again. He's taking out the surgeon's knife in the half court, and he's sticking it in the Red Leafs right now. They have their first lead of the game at 14-12, just under 8 minutes in. No surprise, Steve Hansen will summon Mr. Eric Beckett off the bench to come in and play some physical defense in the post. And they want to get number 10 in as quickly as they can here. Ooh, and that is Seth Dawson, the move. Media timeout called on the floor at 11:53, remaining in this half. Foul being called against two, three, four, five against Sasha Vujicic. I hadn't realized he had checked in, but number 14 getting the call. He is whistled for the foul in the media timeout. We'll keep it right here, Red Leafs TV. I wanted to let everybody in our viewing audience know I've appreciated all your support this year, Red Leafs TV. We have endeavored to work as a team this year on the minor officials table and our production crew, and I am so proud of the job that everyone has done here on Red Leafs TV. And I'm actually not going to be doing the last two games of the season, Saturday's game and of course the season finale. Eitan Weisfeld, our erstwhile producer, will don the headsets and call the last two games, and I know he's going to do an absolutely fantastic job as Red Leafs basketball closes out the regular season here over the next couple weekends. And of course we are itching to get back a game for the new season to play. Simon Fraser, the women on the road today, and we are not trying to say things are over in terms of that, just in terms of regular season play we're talking about here. Simon Fraser women, what a job they've done to take a vault up the standings to fifth place in the standings right now. I think that the first round of the GNAC playoffs open today. The byes to Montana State Billings in Western Washington. Anchorage would be playing Seattle Pacific, and Simon Fraser would be playing Central Washington in a battle of 2-8-7 teams. Of course, that's just if the playoffs were to happen now, but they're in the thick of that playoff race. Bruce Langford has got the team playing well, and they are rolling right now. They are tonight in the Emerald City playing the Falcons at Seattle Pacific at Royal Braun Pavilion. Saturday, the tough one against the division leading or the conference leading Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets. That one a noon tip-off. Right, you can watch that on the, I imagine, on the Montana State Billings YouTube station. A requirement of the GNAC here, all teams streaming their games via YouTube. As the Wildcats step up to the free throw line to build on their lead, Seth Dawson making good at the line, 15-12, a one-possession lead here now. Here's Van Bylent, the handoff. Irish Kokia, pure freshman. To Vujicic, Sasha inside, and he pops that one home with a double team awaiting. Sasha, a nice quick reaction off the bullet from Irish Kokia at the top. There's a skip. Again, Breezy to the basket. This time he can't play the angle off the window. Somehow the ball saved, but it ends up in the hands of Beckett, so a lucky talisman there underneath the basket. Somebody pulled out, and Simon Fraser benefiting. They get the basketball here with 11 minutes remaining in this opening half of play. They trail by one here. Vujicic, the big man out of Burnaby South. Back up top to Kokia. Irish. Beckett will pull up for three. Oh, Eric, just off the mark there. Chase down, recycle. New shot clock here for Kokia. Irish battling on the baseline. He gets it back up top to Penny. Swilly guarding him. Penny shakes him. He gets into the paint, pulls it off the hip. What a beautiful basket from David Penny. David Penny brought the yo-yo and the little booklet that comes with it with all the tricks in it. He put on a show, he lulled you with a little magic, and then he decided he was going to the hole. That is the second basket solely manufactured by DePenny and company here in the opening half of play by the Red Leafs. What a basket by David Penny. 16-15, Simon Fraser back on top, but now defending. This Wildcats team has been so dangerous in the half court. They get a second chance opportunity from Hector's rebound. They feed underneath Jeanette, and a miss underneath. Central has no a make. What am I saying? Apologies. 17-16. Well, I was watching there. Okay, here's Penny again in the half court. Beckett this time on the deck. Back to David for three. Shy, but I think Jeanette got a piece of that. He is a quality defender. Hector Vujicic one-on-one. Sasha. Nice and clean by Vujicic. He gets the stop. Number 14 has come a long ways in terms of his confidence and his ability to stay on the floor. Our officials today, Rob Smith Jr., Derek Davis, Anthony Gregory, the three-man crew in the West Gym here tonight. 20 on the shot clock in the front court. Irish Kokia inbounding. Penny reverses. Vujicic from 13 gets the roll. Sasha not overextending, playing within himself, and he is having a nice half coming off the bench here. And this time he swoops in for the rebound quickly to Beckett. 9 minutes remaining, opening half a play. Simon Fraser with a chance to build on a one-point lead. Here's Beckett. Kokia. Irish just off the mark. That one tipped out of bounds. Should be Simon Fraser basketball. Irish Kokia is St. Pat's Celtics out of East Vancouver. For those of our U.S. friends watching, wondering about number two, in case you are, what his pedigree he is in B.C. high school basketball. He was the MVP of the B.C. Junior Boys Championship. That would be, I guess, for if there's a JV championship in Washington, he was the MVP in the province of British Columbia. Then two straight years at senior varsity, the provincial MVP at 2A in a four-tiered province. Huge, huge talent here for these Red Leafs, and it was a huge signing to get Irish Kokia into Red Leaf colors here atop Burnaby Mountain. Red Leafs replay showing you the Vujicic jump shot. Sasha might not get all the style points in the world, but if you have the ball of an open opportunity, you knock it down at this level, and that's what number 14 does. He's got the ball right now. He gets it back to teammate Beckett. Eric into the paint. Ooh, and coming back, a reach, I think that might be Van Bylent. Yeah, tough one there for Mattis, getting called for the foul. His first of the game, fourth team foul. Is that correct? Central Washington doesn't have a team foul. In this opening half, 8-19 to the break. Seth Dawson into the paint. Big strides by Seth off the window. Lays it up and in. And right back to a Central Washington lead. Lead changes aplenty here. Simon Fraser with a nice quick start. Central Washington with a nice reply. And we've got a one-point game. DeMacky Langan getting the ball from Kokia. Back up top. Irish. He's going to put up a deep three. Oh, look at Elliot DeMacky Langan. Danger pay underneath for the Simon Fraser off guard. Maverick Sanders, I believe, getting called for the foul there, Central Washington. So a timeout on the floor. We'll take a short one here as well. 7:40 remaining. Howard Samura back with more Red Leafs TV. Top Burnaby Mountain in just a moment.
All tickets will be 50% off for these 3 days. Again, that's February 24th, 50% off all.
And we're back with you here, 7:40 remaining. Howard Samura, thanks for joining us on Red Leaves TV. Simon Fraser basketball coming out of the timeout, turned over to Mackie Langan, but he gets it right back. It's a tip drop. No, it is galled up quickly. he gets tapped on the top of the head there by Irish Kokia. That was Samad Hector. Underneath they go, and they come out of the timeout, find some instant offense with Cameron McNeil. Here's Beckett. Simon Fraser, three-point deficit is their largest deficit of this half. Still in the one possession range here. Beckett, double team, passes out of it, seven on the shot clock. Oladele now back on the floor. Shakes, bakes, and rises and knocks it down. Clutch three by Emmanuel Oladele. Oh, they're gonna count that as two. That's a two-pointer. Oh, great job by Oladele. Hits the deck, wins the battle. And here comes Demacki Langan. Emmanuel knocks down the three back-to-back from distance. This time the three ball will fall for Emmanuel Oladele. 23-21 Simon Fraser. Oladele started the game, but took a breather, and he's back. Breathing some fire on the court right now for the Red Leafs. What a job by Simon Fraser. Oladele giving this group a real spark. Take a look at the form there on the Red Leaf TV replay as he is nothing but money there. Oladele did not graze iron, just ripped the mesh and said hello as he came off the pine. 6:06 to the break now, Simon Fraser with the basketball. Terrific game shaping up here as Penny across half court. That's a Kevin Holden. And as I check our box, we really need to, I think, address a mistake I've been making with Holden. So our apologies to everybody in Ellensburg and wherever you may be watching with a rooting interest for Central Washington. That those block numbers on Central's jerseys, I know if you're in the gym, you'll call me blind, and I probably am, but I don't know why I thought that was a one. But Kevin Holden, who was 3 of 4 from the field, I looked at the box score at the last break, and he's the guy. I think I've been going with Seth Dawson. Underneath the basket, and our minor officials crew who told me I was wrong, they are right. Great half here being had by number two, Kevin Holden. Tough hoop there too. Locked at 23, just now over 5 minutes remaining in this opening half. Boy, it's going by fast. Oladele, this time with a feather touch in the paint. He floats it home. So right back to a two-point lead for the Red Leafs. Hector. Underneath they go. Ooh, Van Bylet with some physicality underneath the basket, but that is going to be finished by Swilly, and he's going to knock the score. Demacki Langan. Here's Oladele. What's he got this time in store? He takes a jump stop step to the hoop. And he gets fouled, I believe, in the process. Stone was there to clean up the garbage, but the foul's going to get called against a Maverick Sanders underneath. How about Emmanuel right now? His instincts are just so bang on. Every time he touches the basketball, he's wreaking havoc. And right now with a chance to give his team the lead here from the free throw line, 25-25. And it looks like Angelo Lloyd and Colby Jeanette, number 22, will check in. Of course, we've talked about Jeanette's defense and the difference he makes. A safety net here for Brandon Renta, the head coach, in terms of wanting to tighten up the ship defensively and get his team back on track. He could be a good problem solver there as he lines up. Oladele unable to knock that one down. So here's Holden. Come on. Underneath they go, and right off the bench, post him up, and Colby Jeanette scoring the basketball to give the Wildcats a one-point lead. 4 minutes remaining. Stone at the high post. He'll leave it for Penny. David off the mark there. Oladele with a great offensive rebound. Here's Demacki Langan for three. Elliott off the mark. So a couple of attempts from deep don't go for the Red Leafs. Holden. Woo! And Holden knocks one down to make it 30-26. Yeah, that's a two, or rather, that was a three-pointer, but that is jersey number two. My apologies. Here's Van Bylen. Ooh, and that's going to be a foul on Jeanette, a blocking foul underneath. Nice explosive move by Mattis Van Bylen. Timeout will keep it right here, and we want to thank the rest of our Red Leafs TV crew. We'll give them all a mention again in the second half, but of course, led by our announcer. We should pass along a score right now in the second quarter with 1:48 left in the first half. And that looks like a 33-30 lead for Simon Fraser over Seattle Pacific. So once again, great play by the women's team at home or on the road. They're a completely different basketball team and really priming themselves for what they hope is going to be a run into the GNAC playoffs as the hottest team perhaps in the conference the last couple of weeks. We were going to tell you about the rest of that Red Leafs TV crew, and of course led by the definitive voice of our announcer in the building, Mr. Stephen James, our monitor, replay, and music, courtesy of Nicole Anderson. The scorebook and the spotter, Ethel Latte, Megan Batad. The scorebook operator, Kimo Sanko. Score clock operator, Anita Lawan. Our camera crew in the building today, Julia Hansen, Jose Castro. Our producers, Eitan Weisfeld, Aiden Doherty. And our stats crew, Larissa Dillon, Haley Birch, and Francisco Cresa. Once again on the scene here. The Red Leafs TV crew doing a great job, and we thank all of them for their tremendous contributions to the broadcast here every Thursday and Saturday for Red Leafs home basketball. Whistle blows, the team's now heading back onto the court, and the numbers here, Simon Fraser picking the shooting back up. They're shooting 11 of 27 from the field, 40.7%. The three-pointers falling. 23-point clip, a 3 for 13. Once again, Simon Fraser having trouble getting to the stripe, just 1 of 2 from the free throw line here in this opening half of play. Central Washington shooting it tremendously, 13 of 29. That is a 44.8% percentage. Oladele once again gets right to the scene of the crime, just can't finish it off. 2 of 6, 33% from beyond the arc for the Wildcats. That's Samad Hector once again, kicking it back up top, and this guy cannot miss! Kevin Holden once again, the 6'2 freshman out of Apple Valley, California. Just talked about that three ball. Well, there came another one from Holden. And the lead now up to 7 points, the largest deficit of the game here for Simon Fraser with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left in the opening half of play. Turnaround, tough shot there. And Elliott Demacki Langan, 10 out of 10 on the baseline there. What a great skip, and then Bylett, what instincts to gobble that one up, get his team back down the floor. Oladele wanted the quick hit three, that one falling short. That would have been a big one for Simon Fraser. Take a look at the tough turnaround shot, elevating shoulders square to the basket on the baseline by Elliott Demacki Langan, number 20. Put on the clinic with that beautiful turnaround jump shot. So keep it at 5 points, the deficit for Simon Fraser. Central Washington with the lead in the basketball here in the final 2 minutes of play. Holden, little stutter in the paint, gets it to go off the iron inside. He, like Oladele, purely dialed in here over the latter stages of this opening half. Demacki Langan. Shot clock now at 10. Beckett with the basketball. Turnaround. Ooh, wanted to keep that pivot. It just, according to the referee, unable to hold it. We'll take a look here. If we can see the feet of... Ooh, we couldn't see the feet there in that replay, but referee making the call with authority on the baseline. The turn over to Beckett, and Central Washington now back with the basketball. A 7-point lead. And you know what's on their mind? They'd love a double-digit lead at the half. And the final minute of play here in this opening half. Active hands from Beckett, knocking it out of bounds. Holden, he wants the three. Finally missing. Underneath they go, though, getting a rebound on the nice box out. Great job there by Samad Hector. We mentioned to you the leading scorer, 13.2 points per game, 9.3 rebounds per game, almost averaging a double-double in conference play. Never an easy task here. Sasha Vujicic will come in at the next stoppage for the Red Leafs. Oladele gets the handle, drive and kick, but he's going to get fouled inside. The foul getting called against Angelo Lloyd. Here comes Vujicic in for Stone with 37.7 seconds left and a 9-point lead for the Central Washington Wildcats. Oladele, 20 on the shot clock to inbound. Quickly, ooh, and Penny is going to get manhandled underneath the basket. I believe that's going to be, no, just a reset. No, they will. There is no 20. I think that was Holden. Minor officials will have a talk. There's another turnaround shot. Elliot Tamaki Lang in the mirror image from the same spot on the other side of the baseline. Some muscle memory there for Tamaki Lang. 7-point deficit. Shot clock off here, down to 11 seconds remaining. They'll clarify that foul at the halftime break. There you go, Oladele for the foul. So there's a foul to number 20 that was up on the board here in the gym. And it was not on Demacki Langan, so it was on a Central Washington player. So I don't know whose foul that was. And I should ask the minor officials, was that foul, earlier foul on number 2 or number 20? And indeed it was on number 2, Kevin Holden. Our officials doing a great job here in this opening half. We thank Dan Rob Smith Jr., Derek Davis, and the lead official Anthony Gregory here working the game in Burnaby, British Columbia today. Teams now coming back on the floor for the final 5.3 seconds course. You can join us 5 minutes before the start of every second half of play for our recap and our halftime breakdown show. We'll take a short break here. Once this is over, we'll be back with 5 minutes remaining. Goodness, coach. That was Brandon Rinta, who came out of the coach's box right down to the pass center court to talk to the officials about something. Jeanette, down to 4, down to 3. Fading from the basket. Is a foul going to get called? Ooh. And that was Jordan Clark. 2 seconds remaining. So Simon Fraser with one last look at the basket here. Tamaki Langan, oh, almost stolen away. That's not going to do it. 37-30 is our halftime score here. The Central Washington Wildcats able to get things done. They got some great play off the bench from players like Jeanette and Breezy, as well from Kevin Holden, all off the bench. I'm going to look at those bench points. We'll break those down in about 10 minutes' time as we get set for the second half of play. Central Washington 37, Simon Fraser 30. back with more from the West Gym in moments.
Fantastic job out there tonight.
And welcome back, everybody, at Top Burnaby Mountain, Red Leafs basketball on a rainy Thursday in the province of British Columbia. Thanks for joining us here on the YouTube stream. And I am Howard Samura here with some halftime numbers. And what a job, though, first off, by the Roy Stibbs Elementary Choir from Coquitlam, entertaining with the national anthems at the start of the game and a nice halftime concert here for the nice crowd at the West Gym. Roy Stibbs Elementary in Coquitlam with their fine choir, bringing some nice karma to the building here, the West Gym atop Burnaby Mountain. Some of the numbers from a 37-30 first half lead for Central Washington over hometown Simon Fraser. The big number to look at here, Simon Fraser has taken care of the basketball for the most part. They've had 7 turnovers over that opening half of play, but those 7 turnovers have turned into 15 Central Washington points, 15-3, the edge in points off turnovers. And I bring that to light because 7 turnovers that lead to 15 points, you're virtually giving up a basket every time you commit a turnover. And that's a rate that will not compute well after 40 minutes of play. Simon Fraser, as we said, trailing by 7. They led by as many as 7. Central Washington's largest lead was 9. So the 16-point swing did take place. The turnover situation is something they talked about clearly at the half. As well, what a job by the bench of this Central Washington team. We talked about how well this team broke out of lulls by going to its bench, the points off the bench, 28-4, the advantage. That's about as definitive as you're going to get in the GNAC for Central Washington in that opening half of play. Central Washington also led in points in the paint by +8, 24-16, +3 in fast break points at 6-3. And although both teams had 7 offensive rebounds and those rebounding numbers really, really even over the opening half of play, the efficiency here for Simon Fraser and the ability to stop second chance opportunities inside has got to be a priority for Simon Fraser's team moving forward. And you've seen Zach Stone and Sasha Vujicic for Simon Fraser doing their best inside, joined by the likes of Emmanuel Oladele and company. Eric Beckett, one of those guys as well. Matt has spent violent, really by committee, but they've got to find a way to stop what's pivoting. That pivot action from the post is really playing a big role here for Central Washington. The leading scorers in that opening half of play for Simon Fraser with a team-high 10 points, Emmanuel Oladele. He sat for 4 minutes and 11 seconds out of the 20 minutes. He was 4 of 8 from the field. He hit a 3. He has the only 2 free throw attempts for Simon Fraser in this game. Simon Fraser has got to find ways to get to the stripe. They were 1 of 2 in their 3-point loss to Fairbanks. So over the last 60 minutes of play, Simon Fraser has a total of 4 free throw attempts in 60 minutes. And that is tough sledding. That is not giving yourself a break in terms of putting points on the scoreboard with the clock not moving. So we'll see what can happen here as this second half gets underway. Also 6 points for Elliot Demaculang and 6 points for Zach Stone, 4 apiece for David Penny and Sasha Vujicic. Leading rebounder for Simon Fraser with five is Damaki Lang, and he's got three offensive rebounds. So a solid job on the glass by the guard of Elliot Damaki Lang. Leading the way on the other side, and we mentioned him, Kevin Holden, 7 of 9 from the field, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. He hit his first two triples. He has 16 points to lead all scorers in this contest, the only double-figure scorer for Central Washington, who got balanced looks from throughout the lineup, but we talked about the bench points, and 16 of those coming from Kevin Holden. But really balanced throughout the bench. Mitch Breezy with 4, Kobe Jeanette with 4, Angelo Lloyd with 3, and Seth Dawson with a point. From the starting group, 2 points for Simon Hector, 1 point for Maverick Sanders, Jordan Clark, the only player who has not scored, Brad Swilly with 4, and Cameron McNeil with 2. Now that would be the point scoring look for these teams after the opening half of play. And what a job from the field. Central Washington started shooting just under 40% midway through there at one point, but are up to 48.5% from the field. They're 16 of 33. They're 3 of 8, 37.5% from the three-point arc. And they themselves shooting 50% and only 4 free throw attempts in this basketball game. What else can we tell you? Simon Fraser, 13 of 31. They're 41.9% from the field. 3 of 14 from beyond the arc for 21.4%. And that's the story here through the opening half. The team's now coming back out onto the floor. And Coach Rinta, no surprises, not going with the starting group. He loved what he saw from his bench. And he's got Mitch Breezy, number 44, out there. Kobe Jeanette, number 22. Simon Fraser, I'll tell you, just by a quick glance, I can tell they've got their starters back on the floor. As well, Angelo Lloyd, number 5. And, of course, Kevin Holden. So this is clearly a bench group, Seth Dawson as well. All 5 guys off the bench. Stone tried to get a block from behind. They move it to the baseline corner, had a good look at 3. Damaki Langan punches it out volleyball style. Look for the kill there. Beckett able to squeeze the pumpkin there. So Penny now back down the floor. Central starting group allowed to stew a bit here. They're going to have some purpose when they come on the floor. And Simon Fraser better anticipate the wave of starters that could come onto the floor at any moment here for Central. But right now, this group of non-starters in what is obviously a very deep rotation here for Central, they've been getting the job done. Here's Stone. Makulangan back to Zach. Into the post, trying to shake Breezy, couldn't do it. Damaki Langan, another great bat of the ball into the hands of Stone. The cutter is Oladele. Simon Fraser staying patient, moving around, looking for the good shot. They go back up top. Oladele, Breezy right in his face, knocks down the triple. And Emmanuel Oladele does a great job there now with 13 points in the game. He's 2 of 4, 50% from the field, from three-point range. Loose ball gobbled up by Oladele. Now Penny, he'll leave it for Emmanuel. Stutter step, hesitation, turnaround. On a mini rope there, right into the basket. Oladele, he scores it. He gets the turnover, and he scores it again at the other end. So Emmanuel now with 15 points in this game. Lloyd with the basket there, number 5 for Central. So the 4-point lead for the visitors from Ellensburg, Washington. Of course, dating all the way back to those great NAIA days. These two teams have a mighty history. Here's Oladele. High, low, down to Damaki Langan. A quick pivot turn. Wildcats not biting on anything here. That was going to be 3 the hard way. Doesn't fall for Stone. Underneath off the old board. And that's a great defensive job there on Damaki Langan by Holden. Breezy has the mismatch, able to get rid of the ball, gets Oladele in the air, and Emmanuel is going to get called for the foul. Seth Dawson with some nice play underneath the basket. Take a look at the replay here on our Red Leaf replay as Oladele gets in the air and Seth Dawson just follows through to draw the contact and get to the free throw line. Simon Fraser set to host. Season finishing on a three-game homestand here for Simon Fraser. This being the first of that three-game set. The men and women will play the doubleheader a week this Saturday against Western Washington. That'll be the first doubleheader this team has played this season with a men's and women's team at the same time. Penny, Holden. Ooh, he makes it tough. Kevin Holden playing tough D. We'll see how this one's going to go. Holden is going to get called for the foul. That's a veteran he's dealing with there. And David Penny. David Penny down to the final three GNAC regular season games of his Red Leafs career. Simon Fraser will play Northwest Nazarene, the Nighthawks, this Saturday. Tip off 7 p.m. on Red Leafs TV. Penny with a miss there. Jeanette with a rebound. One possession lead. Wildcats with the lead on the basketball. Ooh, that's a tough turnaround shot there. Degree of difficulty about an 8 or 9 there. Here's DeMacy Langan off the window after the miss by Ezra Lloyd at one end. Elliott, DeMacy Langan coming back on the other and making it happen. So the Red Leafs now within a point here. This has been an especially troubling part for Simon at times this season. These second half starts, put those solid first halves in, but they've made up ground. Step back three, though, is going to go. Kevin Holden has been pure danger here for Simon Fraser. And from the top, he lets it go for a four-point lead. Here's DeMacy Langan. Elliott from 15, contested all the way. Too strong off the back iron. Rebound ripped away there by Hector. Samad Hector's been quiet offensively. It's been guard-oriented. Lloyd back up top to Jeanette. Baseline wide open there. Great little handoff by Holden, but the big man underneath to gobble that one up. Here's Holden again. In his wheelhouse, can't get it to go. Beckett with a rebound. Don't get too close to Eric Beckett or your jaws will pay the price. Jeanette getting out of the way there.
First for the sponsor. Show them. Have you shown them how good it was?
Shot clock down now, down to 10 for DeMacy Langan. Stone makes himself available. Elbow jumper too strong off the back iron. Right into the hands of Hector. Here's Holden. A little hesitation. Dribble to 15, and that one's going to do a little dance and fall for Bradley Swilly. Bella Vista College Prep out of Tacoma, Washington. Native of Tacoma. Entry, double team instantly on Stone. He's got to get the ball out of there. He does. And a nice job there as Simon Fraser finds Nigel Hilton off the bench. And Hilton, who hasn't been getting a lot of playing time, the Toronto native able to make it happen there to make it a four-point game. Here's Beckett. Ooh, a little too much mustard. No, they get right down the floor. And Hilton turns on the Jets, gets fouled coming down the floor. Jeanette had to reach in. And we'll take it. We will keep it here, actually. There's a media timeout on the floor right now. If you take a look at the Red Leaf TV replays, I can let you know, or I should say, did you know that Division II has 293 active member institutions? They have 23 conferences and over 126,000 student athletes. Division II schools are located in 44 states, including Alaska and Hawaii, as well as the District of Columbia. And the Division II also features the NCAA's only international member in Simon Fraser University in Canada, and has three schools in Puerto Rico as well. So Simon Fraser standing alone to such a large extent in the Division II world. And that uniqueness treasured here on Burnaby Mountain. And we just wanted to let you know. And you think about the number of schools, 293. And I think maybe within the U.S. that is not shocking news. You know, when you look at the total membership between Division III, Division II, and Division I, and you add NAIA in there as well as all the junior colleges, Canada, the number so much smaller, and that really gives you a picture of the ocean of competition the lone Canadian school has as it competes for spoils in the NCAA. Of course, in Simon Fraser's NAIA past, this team guided by the likes of Jay Triano, of course, Simon Fraser's most famous basketball alum, who has gone on to carve that incredible career as a head coach and assistant coach in the NBA. And of course, with the Canadian national team and the legendary Stan Stewartson, who really got things going here in the 1970s. Power move underneath, and Hilton can't make that one fall. He got right to the rim. Coming out of the timeout, Simon Fraser trailing by four. Looking for a stop here. Seeing the freshman Maverick Sanders now in the game, as well as Jordan Clark wearing zero. This is the some scatterings of the starting group. Or we should say four of the five are out there right now. I think Kevin McNeil might be the only starter not on the floor, and that's only because red hot Kevin Holden is with this group. That includes Jordan Clark, Samad Hector, and Maverick Sanders among them. Look at the turn he takes to the basket. He's turning a corner like he's on a racing circuit there. That's Kevin Holden. Take a look at that. And he goes to the basket. The foul getting called against Zach Stone, who tried to affect him but was reaching from a stationary position, trying to take some of the purpose out of that turn. And great dribble by Holden. Bradley Swilly. Holden's been doing so much on the floor tonight, you just kind of assume it's him, but Swilly was the guy making it happen there. Well, their free throw trips mounting now for Central Washington. They build a 6-point lead. We told you Central Washington's largest lead was 9 with 52 seconds left in that opening half of play. And they're a made triple away from equaling that. They need to stop first from their perspective. Here's Hilton the penny. Back to Stone, the entry in the post. DeMackie Langan, turnaround jumper doesn't go. He's hit two of those from the baseline corners tonight. Gosh, these central numbers are so hard to read. The single digit ones anyway. There's number zero hoisting the three, Jordan Clark. Hilton now to inbound the basketball. Simon Fraser coming up the floor with David Penny. Penny wants to get the Stone. Zach back up top. Stepping into the three there, Nigel Hilton unable to get that one to fall. So Simon Fraser running their sets in looking for some success off the three ball. If that doesn't fall and they can't get stops at the other end of the floor, they're gonna have to get a little bit more purposeful in terms of what they're doing here. Double team comes, wait, at the great pass out of the double team. Stone with a block shot there. Looked like Zach got a block inside. Here's DeMackey Langham, this time the feed on the block to Hilton. Jeanette, the double team came quickly. Spinning move by Oladele, and they will call, I think, on the defense. And indeed it will. It's going to go against Bradley Swilly. And look at that. That is a driving move. Get a Red Leaf crew to show that one again, because you look at the speed at which Oladele can attack the basket. Well, I think we're getting into play now, but as they do it again, Oladele just puts you at a disadvantage when he is moving without the basketball. He's making those moves off the catch and really can't wait to see what he develops into in coming seasons here. Here he is again, this time to Hilton. Nice move to free himself. Jeanette challenges it, doesn't fall. And ooh, DeMackey Langan took a bit of a fall there. Let's hope that left ankle is okay. Elliott seemed to be favoring it right to the window. How does this Holden kid not start? He's had one of the better performances of any SFU opponent we've seen this year offensively. He is doing it all right now. 48 to 41 point off the largest lead of the game here as we're about 9 minutes into the second half from the West Gym. We'll keep it right here. And I'm going to do some hunting here. I'd love to be able to let everybody know what the score of the SFU women's game is. We don't have a score. Oh, we do. SFU with a 57-51 lead over Seattle Pacific as we get set to start the fourth quarter of play. And the leading scorer, Sophia Wazotsky, what's new, 14 points. Gemma Cutler with 14 and Lainey Shelby with 12. Simon Fraser once again getting it done on the road for head coach Bruce Langford. The Simon Fraser Red Leaf women, as we said, sitting in fifth place. The top six go to the playoffs. Simon Fraser after tonight with two more games remaining, and they can push their record to 9-7 with a victory there against Seattle Pacific, who are right on their tail. Seattle Pacific would then fall to 7-8. There will not be a change, though, in the top six after tonight. Northwest Nazarene sitting with a 6-9 record. And even if they won, they would have a game in hand. Seattle Pacific would still have a game in hand. But Simon Fraser looking to consolidate things, and all depending as well on what the Central Washington women do. Simon Fraser and Central Washington went into play tonight, each tied for fourth place, or you could say one's in fifth, one's in fourth. I don't know what the tiebreaker is between the two, but both teams at 8-7. Simon Fraser has done itself nothing but favors on the women's side since earlier in the season when they were one loss away from falling into the GNAC cellar. And what a spurt that's been for them. The men would love to rekindle their start here in the waning moments, or the final half of this second half of play. Just under 12 minutes remaining. Howard Samura here with you on Red Leaves TV. Thanks for joining us once again from the very top of Burnaby Mountain. Emmanuel Oladele, Hilton on the block, Jeanette guarding him. Turnaround shot, gets the stuff, but Hilton gets it right back. This time back up top to Oladele. He gets shut off on the top of that zone. Shot clock's down to two. Kokia was trying to get a hold of it. Guess who's gonna score? Once again, the man of the moment, Kevin Holden, the 6'2 freshman. Kevin is a freshman out of R.A. Long High School. His hometown is Apple Valley, California. Shout out to everybody watching number two here on Red Leafs TV tonight. What a performance he's putting on. For those who have followed him since his high school days, swelling with pride here. As he's controlling things on the floor in a 10-point lead, his basket makes it the largest lead of the game for Central Washington. Ooh, and that's a dagger. That one from Angelo Lloyd. Jello making it fall there, a 13-point lead. Simon Fraser in danger of slipping off the edge here. That one on the handoff goes out of bounds off Nigel Hilton. Right now, the simpatico not there in the West gym. We're going to take a break here. Timeout on the floor. We'll be back with a final 10-28 of this basketball game from the top of Burning Mountain. It's Central Washington 53, Simon Fraser 40. And the whistle, the horn rather, brings us back here to the West Gym. Watching all those great replays, we thank our producing team of Eitan Weisfeld, Aiden Doherty as usual, our camera team of Julia Hansen and Jose Castro. Thank you for catching all the action here for Red Leafs basketball. Simon Fraser at their lowest ebb of the evening. They sit with a 13-point deficit with 10:27 remaining, and they are defending coming out of the timeout. Jeanette the skip down low. Stone does his job standing his ground underneath as Samad Hector tried to exert himself in the post. Here's Olodele. Clear out. And he gets to the rim. The whistle blows and a nice set run there. Stone, or Vujicic rather, showing that lower body strength in the post. He vacates just in time for the drive to the basket, and Olodele, who gets where he wants to go in a hurry on the basketball court, is going to get to the free throw line here. Simon Fraser still. No, we don't have, where's my latest score sheet? We want to check on those free throw trips. Simon Fraser has struggled to get to the stripe, and this time they're going to get one to fall. The tenets of the game here, the three-point shot added in the last 40-plus years, but the free throws and made field goals. You can't win without them. You need the free throws, too. It's an indication of your ability to put the defense in some jeopardy here, and Simon Fraser is just not getting enough of them right now. They get one of two to make it an 11-point game. Oh, and there's Sasha. Vujicic rises, uses every bit of his wingspan. And the 6'11" Burnaby South Rebel does a great job to knock it out of bounds. Oh, what a great dish underneath to Hector. Brad Swilly in perfect connection there. Underneath feeds for the lay-in and right back to a 13-point lead. And right there, Kevin Holden will rise for the dunk. And that's now the largest lead of the game, now at 15. Simon Fraser has lost their mojo here tonight at the West Gym. They'll battle hard, you know they will, right to the final buzzer to get it back, but The momentum building on every play here for the Wildcats. Swilly again, Penny comes in too hard, and David, the veteran, will get called for the foul. Two more games remaining after tonight for Simon Fraser, and we talked about those heartbreakers on the road. You gotta come back from those, you gotta shake them, you gotta put them to rest in a hurry. Simon Fraser losing 83-81 in double overtime a week ago to the Anchorage Seawolves, and Vujicic comes in hard. And then two days later, 74-71. Alaska, the toughest trip in the conference, and to lose two games back-to-back, one in double overtime, and both by one possession. That is adversity defined here in the GNAC in terms of the sacrifices made to make that push for that final playoff spot. And make no mistake, Simon Fraser was right in that race, and right now needing to retain ballast for even a mathematical chance, it's all slipping away here with 8:40 remaining. Samad Hector making good on that one, so the lead now at 17 points. Here's Oladele. Ooh. Swilly wanted to travel, but he's going to get... Oh, I'm sorry, Angelo Lloyd. Jamaki Langan puts up the three, gonna rattle that one home. Elliott with a triple. Makes it a 14-point game. Sasha coming in strong at the other end of the floor, the ball going over the goal. Steve Hansen right in front of a broadcast location, imploring his guys to get it in quick. Here's Beckett. Beckett, Penny cutting, double team comes quickly to Mackie Langan. Standstill three with a man in his face, tough shot there, couldn't get that one to go just off the mark, but the whistle blows, and looks like, based on the reaction on the floor, that Lloyd's gonna get called for the foul. You see it underneath there as he affects the rebounding opportunity of Vujicic underneath the basket. Timeout call on the floor, and Simon Fraser and Central will head to the sidelines here. Seniors night will be an emotional one, as always. It'll come up on March the 2nd, a week this Saturday, as Simon Fraser's men and women play at 5:15 and I believe 7:30. The women with the first game, Western Washington, of course, their travel partner in town for that game, coming up the, making a short drive up the I-5 from Bellingham. Of course, Carmen Dolfo will coach that women's team, as she has for so many years now, the former Penticton Lakette, as they would say in those days. Going up against Bruce Langford, and the men's game again will be hotly contested. In Western Washington, the men have been a surprise this season. When they came up here for a Division II tournament in November, saw how they looked, and they looked like the best team that was here, and certainly there's no denying the quality, but they've got more than their share in the L column than they're probably used to and that they thought they'd have. It's been that kind of a season in the GNAC. Montana State Billings coming in tonight with that 13-2 record to lead all teams. St. Martin's, Northwest Nazarene each at 10-4, Central Washington 8-6, Anchorage at 7-7, Seattle Pacific at 7-8. Those are the six playoff teams right now. And so Western Washington, a big one tonight as they played host to Northwest Nazarene, really trying to get off the schneid and make a push. Could still be a lot on the line in terms of Western Washington when that game happens a week from Saturday. David Penny getting called for the foul. No, was that my mistake? Did I not hear them say number three? No, obviously for Central, Swilly. So Simon Fraser cashing in there to make it a 12-point game. Simon Fraser has got it in him to knock down some shots and make a bit of a rally quickly. Refs in discussion here, teams heading to the sidelines. I don't know if there's a video review potentially on tap here. We'll see what the officials want to do. I think they... And they will indeed go to the replay monitor here, courtside, with our minor officials. Me one last time. I'll try not to get misty-eyed because I love this minor official stable and all the hard work they do on Red Leafs TV. And it's my final broadcast of the year. As I said right off the top, I won't be here for the final two SFU games tomorrow against Nazarene and or Saturday rather against Nazarene in a week Saturday when the doubleheader happens against Western Washington. And as I mentioned, our producer Eitan Weisfeld will handle the play-by-play chores there. Both he and Aiden Doherty today, again, doing a great job as our producers. Our stats crew, Larissa Dillon, Haley Birch, and Francisco Cresa. Our announcer, Stephen James. And our camera operators today, Julia Hansen, Jose Castro, among the many here, helping to get us on the air and streaming. Yeah, they are checking something there, just in terms of, I believe that was... Is that 33 Sanders who took the big fall there? They're not sure what they're doing, but they're coming away from their scrum. I just wanted to check to make sure that David Penny indeed was getting called for the foul there. So his third of the game now. 7:37 remaining. Simon Fraser played great basketball here in the opening half and waned a bit before the start of the second half, but Central Washington came out and made some things happen quickly and built the lead. Simon Fraser's done some nice work to cut it back down. I believe it was at 17 or 19 at one point. It's now down to 12, but the clock's soon the enemy here of the Red Leafs. And Central Washington is going to play some purposeful time-eating possessions here in the half court. That miss there gobbled up by Vujicic. Angelo Lloyd with a miss from downtown. Here's Penny. Simon Fraser needs to make things happen. They need some ball movement here as well to get their shooters going. Ooh, and some contact underneath away from the ball, and it's going to come in the post against, I believe that's going to be Maverick Sanders. Nope, my mistake. That is Colby Jeanette underneath. And you know what? Eric Beckett's a load. He's going to bring his frame in there, and he's going to make you work. And as he's joined this team late, he has been a revelation. I'm trying to think of a full season of Beckett. Certainly a plus for the Red Leafs for the end of this season and into next. Bonus was in effect, missed the top end there. And Boy, there's bodies crashing everywhere underneath the basket, and Beckett's being helped up every time. Holding the drive, the dish. And the three ball there by Samad Hector off the mark, but bodies crashing underneath the basket. So Holden being called for the foul there, his fourth of the game. Here's to McElhangan. Red Leafs would dearly love to do something that brings this crowd back to life and get them off of their hands here as they're looking for something to cheer for. Here's to McElhangan, displaced to the ball there. Tough defense from Swilly. Shot clock's now down to six for Penny. The veteran into the paint. And he will lay it up and in. There's the leader stepping up and making a big basket to make it a 10-point game. Simon Fraser carving out a bit of a run here. Certainly the offense not coming with real flow. They're having a battle tooth and nail here for everything, and it's not helping with the game clock ticking. But can they come up with another stop here? Here's Holden. He has done it all from the inside and the outside. Shot clock's down to five. Crashing into the paint right as the shot clock's going to expire, Angelo Lloyd, and the whistle blows and the foul's going to get called against Emmanuel Oladele, his fourth personal. So Lloyd from Seattle, Washington, a Kentwood High grad, a senior at 6'2", 170, now at the free throw line. Makes them both to make it a 12-point lead. You gotta credit this space-eating Central Washington defense in the half court. Oladele, though, oh, that's, he tried to put a funky angle off the window. Couldn't score it, took a big knock underneath as well. Central Washington makes it obtuse out there for you. They just don't give you the ability to look graceful out there. Oladele, though, with his quickness, has been one of those guys, Penny as well, that's been able to break that down on occasion. But for the most part, they turn it into an obstacle course when you want to get to the basket. Here's Oladele. The bonus knocks down the front end to make it 61-50. That one will roll home, right back to 10 points. Still time here for Simon Fraser. They just need to put together a sequence. Central turned the game, I think, late in the first half on a tough bucket and a steal for a three, and that five-point burst in this low-scoring game made a big difference. Oh, and Vujicic, Sasha, times it perfectly. What a block by Vujicic as he swats Swilly underneath. Here's Penny. That's a beautiful drive to the basket from David Penny to make it an 8-point game, and this is what we're talking about. Someone just opened the back door here at the gym and let a nice breeze of fresh air in, figuratively speaking. And as soon as that happens, Brandon Rinta, the head coach, calls for time. He wants to talk things over as we take a look at the action on our Clan TV replay. Look at the timing there from Sasha, the big man, gaining confidence in the open floor to come in for that beautiful block. And here's Penny. He gains the edge and protects the ball as well as anybody in the conference. Those moments of suspended animation there. Rising with the ball on his hip, and we're going to miss number three next season in Red Leaf colors. The Red Leafs getting ready to hit the floor again. Oladele, Demaculangan, Penny, Vujicic, and Beckett will be the five Red Leafs. And it's Holden. Swilly number three, number five is Angelo Lloyd, number 24 the big man Samad Hector, and who am I missing? The man inbounding the ball, Colby Jeanette. Those are the five Wildcats on the floor now. Simon Fraser cuts this thing to eight. Three ball is shy, could have been partially blocked. Vujicic with a save right into the hands of Oladele. Sasha coming up big on the defensive end. Down the stretch, and he's staying on the floor here for these Red Leafs. 4 minutes, 12 seconds, and a turnover Simon Fraser doesn't want. Is that a moving screen, perhaps, called by Vujicic? Yeah, I think so, although he looked like he was set. Tough break there for Simon Fraser. They got a battle, trying to get another stop. From their perspective, they got to play lockdown defense with 4 minutes remaining. Holden to Jeanette. Beckett guarding him. Holden down to Hector. Samad underneath. Oh, had a move that seemed to have froze Vujicic, but Hector unable to follow through. Now the ball right down the floor it goes. Leaving it underneath, Beckett blocked, but he gets it back. Looking for Vujicic, I think. Ooh, and nothing's going Simon's way on the possessions. They are gonna have to get back and play some defense here. Nice play in the physicality department there, underneath from Beckett and Vujicic, but the cavalcade of Caroms just not going their way here. Possession would have been huge with 3:34 left and an 8-point deficit coming out of this timeout with a chance to scheme with the basketball, but instead it's going to be Central Washington ball. And looks like a huge night down in Seattle, 77-69. Goodness gracious, Sophia Wysotski on fire today. She scored a career high 32 points. She was, I'm not sure what she was. We can maybe take that as her season stats, but she, we should just give you this, was 3 of 7 from beyond the arcs, but she was 11 of 12 from the free throw line. What a night. She had 32 points, 14 points for Lainey Shelby, and 16 for Gemma Cutler. So a big, huge win for Simon Fraser on the road today. They get it done against Seattle Pacific, and that's going to push the Simon Fraser women's basketball record to a sterling 9-7 after 16 games. They have two more remaining. The Simon Fraser women will be at Montana State Billings. Boy, what a game that's going to be. Montana State Billings leading the GNAC at 13-1. Red hot Simon Fraser heading in there with a 9-7 record and looking to wreak some havoc in the great state of Montana, en route to a week of prep to build for the season finale, March the 2nd, against the Western Washington Vikings right here at the West Gym. Of course, that one right here on Red Leafs TV. Back to the men's game now. Simon Fraser trailing by 8. 3:34 remaining. And the inbounds here from the Wildcats. Simon Fraser's timeout centered around a defensive stance and a reaction to that. They want to get the stop here. They'd love to come down and try and make it a two-possession game, but they got to get a stop first. Still plenty of healthy clock here for the guys from Ellensburg. Hector back up top. He goes for three. That one's not going to go. A beautiful rebound off the miss by Swilly. That's Oladele. The lob to Beckett in the corner. Eric back up top. He goes to Penny. They'll set it up now with 3 minutes remaining. And a made basket of the regulation variety makes it a two-possession game. Behind the back pass, not to the intended receiver. Beckett will improvise. He'll play some jazz here underneath. He's going to turn, face, and square, and get the roll. Eric Beckett with a big basket there. He makes it 61-55. It's a six-point lead. Simon Fraser needs a stop in a hurry. 20 on the shot clock would give Simon Fraser about 2:10 remaining if they can get a stop and Central uses the whole shot clock. Both teams in the bonus here, 2:24 remaining. Vujicic reach gets quickly back on defense to guard Hector in the post. Inside they go, the lane was open and it's an end-one opportunity. Exactly not what you wanted to see. That's a tough break as you watch our replay here. Nice crossover move. And Penny is going to get called for his fourth foul of the game. That's a perplexing situation for the senior to be in. He does not want to commit the foul and try to move his feet there as Angelo Lloyd, the senior himself from Seattle, able to complete the end one. So it's back to a 9-point lead. Simon Fraser. They need to make something happen here. Here's Penny to Mackie Lang, and a money three is not going to go from the baseline corner. Now under 2 minutes remaining. Holden trying to beat to Mackie Lang, and Elliott with a steal at half court. Quickly back to Oladele. He gets in rhythm, baseline three, and he gets it. The rim reached out its arms and said, yes, you will fall. Cradled off the iron, off the window, and down to make it a two-possession game once more. Take a look at it at DeMackie Langan's shot. The beautiful spiraling release finds its way home. So with 1:40 left, but Central Washington in the meantime stepping up to the free throw line. Now Swilly off the foul committed there. And that's going to go there. DeMackie Langan hit the three but got called for the foul only a second of the game, but a untimely one at this point. And the Wildcats are not missing their free throws down the stretch. They're going to rattle both of those home. So that is a tough, tough call to hit the three and give up two. At least from SFU's perspective, the clock was stopped. Here's to DeMackie Langan, trying to use the Vujicic high screen. Instead, he puts up the shot anyway, and he gets it to fall to DeMackie Langan. He makes it a 5-point game. Simon Fraser can't be too placid here on defense. I guess they are gonna just let the shot clock go here. Just wanna get the stop and get the ball back. Baseline, reverse is gonna go. Swilly, Simon Fraser in that no man's land right now, not wanting to commit the foul, conscious of the clock, having to maybe play off a little, and look at that job there. That is a gorgeous basket by Bradley Swilly, the 6'5 freshman. How about DeMackie Langan? That was playtime hoops there, letting that deep, deep, deep three go. DeMackie Langan has back-to-back triples here. Spectacular response to what Simon Fraser needs. But at the same time, this Central Washington team, which came in today with that 8-6 record, sitting fourth overall in the GNAC, showing their quality, extending the arm, playing a bit of keep away in terms of the figurative margin of their lead right now, back to 7 points. So Simon Fraser in a definite pickle here. Both teams in the timeout right now. Our referees today, Rob Smith Jr., Derek Davis, and the lead official today is Anthony Gregory. A Again, if you're just joining us, we can pass on a quick score for a Red Leafs fan. Simon Fraser heading down to get the victory tonight at Seattle Pacific. Down to the Emerald City to get the win. Now the big drive over, or the big trek over to Montana State Billings. They will face the Yellow Jackets on Saturday. That one with a 5:15 game time on MSUB, their stream, if you're interested in watching Simon Fraser women's basketball. Of course, the men would follow. You can watch them back-to-back because I think the 7 o'clock game here, yes, Saturday against Northwest Nazarene. And those Nighthawks from Nampa, Idaho, even better record than Central. They are 10-4 heading into play tonight, so no easy ones here for the Red Leafs down the stretch. That 7-point advantage really putting the impetus on a quick hitter here. Simon Fraser needs more than just 2 3-point buckets. It's about a 30-second difference on the clock, so just under that. Here they go, Beckett's got to put it up. Oh, and he hits it, and he's fouled in the process. Eric Beckett, the magic touch. He can make it a one-possession game with 36.7 seconds left. Look at the focus as he steps into it. Eric Beckett, the magic man, wearing number 10, knocks down the big triple there. He'll step up to the free throw line. Sixty-four, tough one there. 27 seconds, 5 seconds difference in the clocks here. And Penny will foul. Certainly this game not without its moments here tonight. You see Penny fouling at midcourt. Irish Kokia, number 2, now set to come into the basketball game. Penny fouling out of the game with his 5th infraction of the contest here with 21.2 left, a 5-point lead now. Simon Fraser will potentially look at the latter stages, their late surge here, and their ability to get themselves back into basketball games. There's been a number of these occasions. They've trailed by as many as 17 points. They got it all the way down to 3. But here is right back up to 6. So get over half court, call the timeout quickly with 17.2 seconds left. Can't sugarcoat the season. It's been a tough one here with a very, very inspiring surge late in the season by Steve Hansen's team. There's no question this team struggled to find itself in the early going. And to magnify the importance of every win in this conference, there's been a number of occasions where the games have just gotten away from them. And the basketball pundits will say, well, that's a trademark of a team that is still building, trying to find the pieces they need to do what they need on a daily, on a week-to-week basis in this conference to be able to withstand the different styles and skill that they're going to face, the conditions they will face with travel in the GNAC. And so you can look at a record and it'll reflect a lot of truths. And Simon Fraser, I think from the perspective of looking on the entire season, really finished with forward momentum here as they've gone. They are putting the pieces together here. They will lose David Penny among the main rotation players, but they'll also, from a very positive standpoint, have so many back. And if they stick with the program here and if some new recruits can be brought in, I know that's a song you're going to hear a lot of in basketball circles anywhere you go. But certainly look like the look of what is potentially shaping up here as the game ticks down to 17.2 and the Red Leafs trailing by six. And not trying to put any finality on this. Maybe I should be more in the present. This is my final broadcast of the season. So certainly Simon Fraser with an opportunity here. Just needs some big shots to fall in a hurry. Here's DeMacy Langan. He's going to pull up. He's going to dial up the three. And he's going to knock it down. And it's a gain, a one-possession game. Take a look at Elliott. He has been on fire, uncontested. Not wanting to foul him from three, knowing the danger of him hitting that shot, but they give it up, and DeMacy Langan knocks it down, but fouling very quickly. DeMacy Langan has hit three triples here down the stretch drive of this game. But how about the efficiency of Central Washington from the free throw line? They've been getting it done from the stripe here. They just keep to manage to maintain that distance they need here. Ooh, and this time just going one of two. Simon Fraser with 6 seconds left. They want to adjust the clock. They say it started early. So the referee's right on top of that. It's at 6.1, but they're going to add a little bit here, I think. Steve Hansen campaigning for 8 seconds. Referees are going to talk this one over for a second. We'll stay with you here on Red Leafs TV. Once again, a great shot of that three-pointer. Stick around. We'll wait around for the final box score following the completion of this game, give you the numbers and the breakdown right here on Red Leafs TV. I know to our production crew, we'll stick with it till we get that final box and throw out some numbers and set you up for Saturday's game here against Northwest Nazarene with a 7 p.m. tip. Here's Beckett, 7.3 seconds left. Simon Fraser trails by four. Once again, is he gonna pull up for the quick three? The deep three! Oh, just off the back iron, tipped around, and that's gonna do it. DeMacy Langan had a look. It would have left them 1 point short, and in the final analysis, Central Washington guts one out here. Simon Fraser gets hot late. Elliott DeMacy Langan wielding potential daggers at the end, but not enough of them to get the Simon Fraser Red Leafs over the hump tonight. They will fall and be swept in the season series here. 71-67, the final score. Central Washington with the victory. And we'll wait for a final box score here. And once we get our copy, we'll let you know what happened here. Simon Fraser, a tough one. I just want one, thank you, and we'll give you the box score numbers here. 71-67, the final score. Central Washington, boy, Central Washington had four free throw trips in the first half. They were 2 of 4. They had 15 of them in the second half. They were 80% from the stripe, 12 of 15 in the second half from the free throw line. That cures a lot of ills in a tight, tight basketball game down the stretch drive. They were 14 of 19, 74% overall from the stripe, 5 of 14, 36% from three, and 46% from the field, 26 of 56 here tonight. The leading scorer is the leading scorer in the game, Kevin Holden, 11 of 14, including 3 of 5 from the arc, 25 points lead all scores, 15 points for Brad Swilly, 13 for Angelo Lloyd. They are the top three scorers here for Central Washington. For Simon Fraser, we're wrapping up quickly. Damaki Langan with 20. He was 4 of 7 from the arc, beyond the arc, 9 of 17 overall. 22 points for Elliot Damaki Langan. Emmanuel Oladele with a big game as well. 6 of 12, 5 of 6 from the stripe. He had 19 points and in a fine performance over 31-26. The total rebounds in this game, 71-67 Central Washington. Simon Fraser actually had more offensive boards. He actually did a good job with those 11 offensive boards tonight, but they were out-rebounded by a single Karam, 35-34. Points in the paint, a 10-point advantage for Central Washington at 38-28. That was a big one. And off the bench, 47-6. That shows the depth of the Central Washington team. 47-6 in bench points, and that's the stat that might tell the story here tonight from the West Gym. For everybody watching, I've finished my 21st season of Simon Fraser broadcasts, and I want to thank everybody here. We've gone through the names throughout the night, but especially our producers here on Red Leaf TV, Eitan Weisfeld, Aidan Doherty, and thanks to everybody watching. I will join you again next season, but please be here Saturday as Eitan gives you the play-by-play at 7 p.m. of Simon Fraser versus Northwest Nazarene. Everybody, drive safely, and we will see you again on Saturday.